Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video, I'm going to show you how you can store a radio button value in Firebase real-time database with auto increment. So as you can see on the screen that when I will give some demo name like John, and after this when I will choose the gender male, and when I will click on this button save, so as you can see that the child here is created of name user, and its first value is gender is male and name is John. And when I will change this value again, I will close this app and I will rerun this app. So you can see when I will give any random name and again choose this, and I will click on this save button, so you can see that child is incremented. So today in this video, I'm going to show you how you can do this in your Android app. So without wasting time, let's start. So guys, storing value. So for storing value of radio button in Firebase real-time database, first of all, we will create activity underscore XML file. So as you can see on the screen that our parent layout is constant layout, so I will change it to linear layout. And then I will give it gravity center. So give it gravity center, and orientation will be vertical. And after this, here we will use edit text. Yes, because we will take input the user's name, and then after this we will use radio button. So simply write edit text, and width will be 300 dp, and then its height will be wrap content, and text we will not use text, we will use hint. So simply write hint, and hint will be name, and then id will be name underscore et. And then after this we will give it text color android black, and text size will be 20 sp. yeah, now it's fine. So after close it, and then here we will use two radio buttons. So first radio button will be wrap content. I think it should be height wrap content, but we will give it width 100 dp, because when you give it wrap content, then whenever you give text, so the size don't look good. That's why I'm using 100 dp, and I will give it text. So whenever we use radio button, then there is only two condition, that if it is true or false. So its id will be male. Let me give it small. Yeah, now it is looking good. Then after this, simply copy it and then paste it below this. And now we will give it text. So change its text to female, and id will be also female. Yes. Now as you can see that our layout file is almost complete, but here I will give it margin bottom. So margin bottom will be 20 dp, and then here after this radio buttons, I will use a button for storing value. So button and wrap content, and text will be save, and margin top 20 dp. Yeah guys, after this id, and id will be save btn. Yes, so now as you can see that now our activity underscore XML file is complete, and I have, now it's time to go to mainactivity.java. So guys, here first of all I will show you this member activity. So I have already created this for saving time, because I just want to make this video small and useful. So as you can see on the screen that in this video I have simply created two strings, private string name, private string gender, and there is empty constructor, and for real-time database. And after this I have created getter and setter methods. So hope you know how to do this, because if you don't know, then simply click right and then go to generate, and you can find that methods from there. So after this method, let's back on mainactivity.java. So here first of all we will declare all the variables. So write button, and for this I will simply write b, and then after this member, because the class that we have created, after this radio button. So radio button will be male and female, because I'm giving the gender, because I want to make it super simple. So after this we will give it Firebase database. So simply write database, and then database reference. So database reference, so it should be reference. And then after this, here we will declare an integer value for incrementing data. So integer I equals to 0. And now last thing is that edit text. So oops, let me give it value edit text, and its name will be name. Yeah, so after that, after guys, what we will do inside on create, we will give it reference. So simply write b equals to find view by id r dot id dot, oops, find view by id r dot id dot name et, oops, not name et, because this is save btn, so save btn, yes. And then after this member, so equals to new member, and then after this we will give it mail equals to find view by id r dot id dot male, and then female equals to find view by id r dot id dot female, and then edit text name equals to find view by id r find view by id r dot id dot name et. Yes, so guys, now we have given all the references. So after this here we will write reference equals to database dot get instance dot get reference dot child, and child's name will be user, and then after this here we will use reference dot add value event listener, then new on value event listener, so oops, value event listener, yes. So now guys, inside this on data change, what we are doing, that you can see that there are two methods, on data change, on cancelled. So on cancelled, you can simply show a toast message that data failed, data not saved. So and on inside on data change, what we will do is we will simply write if data snapshot exist dot so if there is any change in data, then what will happen, that I, that variable, integer variable we have declared, so it will simply declare the increment that value. So write database snapshot dot get children count, yes, and after this semicolon. So what will happen, that whenever the data will change in database, so it will automatically increment. So after this, and inside on cancel, you can do whatever you want, you can show a toast message. So after this here we will use that button, so b, then set on click listener method, new on click listener method, and inside this what we will do is simply we will declare two strings, string m1 equals to mail dot get text dot to string, and then after this again string, and its name will be m2 equals to female dot get text dot to string, and after this we will use if statement. So if, yes, if mail dot is checked, then what will happen, that if the mail is checked, then member, that class that we have created, member dot set gender m1, and then after this we will write reference dot, oops, reference dot child string dot value of I plus 1. So now you can see that it will automatically increment that value whenever the set value member, yeah, after the semicolon. And else, if male is not checked, if female is checked, then what will happen, that member dot set gender m2, because our m2 is female, and after this again simply copy this line, reference dot child set, so simply copy this from here and then paste it here, and then above this if statement here what we will do is simply write member dot set name, so here we will write name dot get text dot to string, yeah guys, now it's fine, and again copy this line here, yeah guys, now the coding part is complete. So before running this app, make sure you have given the internet permission in your Gradle build. So if you will not give it, then maybe the data will not save in real time database. So without wasting time, it's time to run the Android app and see it is working or not. In case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section, I will try to reply in next 24 hours. So open Firebase database, yes, So guys, now our app is running successfully. As you can see that there is no error, and this is our Firebase real-time database. So after this, I will give a random name, and after giving name, I will choose this radio button mail, and when I will click on save btn, so as you can see that there is a child created user, and its first value is mail. I mean gender is male and name is Rajan Sharma. And if I will close this app again, and I will run this again, so the integer that we have used, so if I will give her name Shruti and I will choose its gender female, and after choosing this, if when I will click on this button, save button, so you can see that the child is incremented now and gender is female and name is Shruti. So hope you like this video. So please subscribe my channel and share this video, and if you like this video, then don't forget, and also press the bell icon, because I will upload more interesting videos like this in future. So thank you for watching.